Washington Post and says Robert Griffin's done for good. Jay Gruden wants him out of here. Is it true?
Well, I'll say what is true is that from talking to multiple people, Jay Gruden is done with Robert Griffin III. Whether or not the people above Jay Gruden are done with Robert Griffin III, I can't speak to that. But Jay Gruden, from what multiple people have told me, he's seen the film. Sean McVay, the offensive coordinator, he's seen the film. And what they've determined is they simply cannot, they have no chance to win with this guy playing quarterback right now. And it's not just the footwork, the being too methodical in the reads and having no pocket presence. It's all the other stuff. So, you know, could he start? Yeah, again, he could start if someone forces Jay Gruden to start him.
All right, Grant Paulson, you are literally about to jump out of your seat right now. You're so excited to talk about this. Can they win with Robert?
Well, they're not going to, because I don't think he's going to play here. I think he's going to win in the league again somewhere. They're going to design an offense for him comparable to what Kyle Shanahan and Mike Shanahan did in 2012, and he can have success that way. But as a pocket passer in Jay Gruden's offense, no, I don't see that working. You asked Jay an interesting question, though. You said, is Jay Gruden done with Robert Griffin? My answer to that is yes. My other question to you guys would be, was he ever in on Robert Griffin? I don't think he was. You talk about a guy that I think moved on from Griffin before the season started. In the Baltimore preseason game, he's watching that game going, can this guy run my offense? And he determined watching the film that he couldn't. Then he wanted to hope that Kirk Cousins took the offense and ran with it after Griffin played one game and one possession. And so you move on a little bit later on in the season, the guy plays four games in your offense, and you've essentially decided, not for me. I just don't think Robert Griffin ever made Jay Gruden think he was his guy.
See, I like this, that I kind of run this. I'm the king of the castle, the king of the castle. And so I'll ask you now, Diana, is Jay Gruden the king of the castle in Redskins Park? Can he make decisions not only with Robert, but he talked about a lot of players throughout that team, and especially on defense, maybe not playing, and him saying, no dice, get out.
You're calling him the king of the castle. You're calling yourself the king of the castle.
But is he?
The true king of the castle is Dan Snyder. So if he brought Jay Gruden on to develop Robert Griffin III, there's a disconnect here. What are we missing here? Did Dan Snyder know this?
But here's what everyone says, and I don't buy this. Everyone thinks because Robert Griffin was so important to the organization that when Jay Gruden was hired, it was passed down to him that you have to fix Griffin, that he was some type of Robert Griffin whisperer. I don't buy that. I don't think he gets the job if he tells Bruce Allen at the time, I don't want to work with him. But I genuinely don't believe before he got here he didn't want to work with him. I just think it took quicker than maybe Jay Gruden would have liked for him to determine Griffin wasn't his guy. But at that point, the mandate if you're Jay Gruden when you go to Dan Snyder and Bruce Allen is, I'm here to win for the Redskins. I'm not here to win with Robert Griffin. I'm here to win, period. And so there's a big difference between those two things.
What would you whisper to Robert Griffin? If you could be a whisperer, what would you say, Jay Reid, to Robert Griffin? And you can whisper it if you want.
Well, I won't whisper it, but I'll say this, Chris. What I would say to him is, you need to go somewhere else. You need to go somewhere else and start over. This organization needs to start over. And what I would also say to him is, you don't want to be here, because if you're here, the head coach doesn't want you, and he's being forced to keep you because of things that constantly happen in this organization that are not about football.
By the way, there was a report out late this week that we might see Griffin back on the field again, which I think is preposterous. The report, not necessarily the idea. If you see Robert Griffin back on the field before the end of this season, it's going to mean that Jay Gruden didn't make that decision, that the owner, Daniel Snyder, and the president and general manager, for some reason, Bruce Allen, made that decision. And if that's the case, that's a problem. And this organization is in a bad spot because the head coach isn't making the calls on football decisions.
Let's end this with this. Let's play a yes or no game. Just yes or no. Does someone take a hit for this if Robert Griffin leaves here at the end of this year?
No.
Yes.
Yes. And I think we both know we're talking about the same person. And
I don't know if we
are. I know who I'm talking about.
I think the only one that's out of here is on defense.
Wait. Who are you talking about?
Well,
I'd like to know.
Let me say this. I don't know how much time we have left in this segment. But if Robert Griffin III is out of here, there is one person who's still in this organization who had a heck of a lot to do with bringing him here. It wasn't just Mike Shanahan. And if he's out, that person should be out too.
I don't know if that person's out.
Can you whisper it to me?
I'll whisper it off camera.
Well, Diana, who's out on defense?
I think this is going to be a tough season for Jim Haslett to survive. I mean, just look at the numbers right now. Look how much they're struggling. Look at what they did last Sunday. That was probably one of the worst performances. Why do you disagree with this, Grant?
I don't disagree with this. I wouldn't be surprised at all if at the end of the year Jim Haslett is fielding phone calls from other teams. The good news for him is that there's going to be six or seven teams that try to hire him immediately. But he is trying to make filet mignon at a hamburger helper. You can't be a good defensive coordinator with poor personnel. You can't do epic things with basic people, as DeSean Jackson, oh the great gosh. Philosopher, once said. And that's what Jim Haslett's trying to do.
And don't tell me that Jay Gruden owes him the favor and says, oh, you know, he hired Jay Gruden back in the Arena League. One favor, it's done. The favor was he survived this season, or at least he was on the staff this season. They're even now. It's time to move forward and find somebody that can run this defense, because right now
I like this short answer game, so I'm going to give you guys another one. Fix this defense. How many new starters do we need going into next year? Jason Reed.
Two at safety, two at linebacker, two on the offensive
line.
Four. The answer is four.
Five.
No.
Diana?
I'm saying five.
No, the answer is five. The answer is five.
He's got it.
I had to add it up.
Round up to carry the nine.
Play really good defense.
And we got it.
With four more starters. Of course, you'd like to wholesale changes. Yeah. It's hard to do.
Well, obviously, the math department at USC isn't very strong. But Colt McCoy, guys, is he the future of the Redskins?
I think he could be a placeholder here next year. I genuinely believe that. I mean, he can run the offense well enough. As long as, for me, the Redskins don't feel like they have to find their quarterback this offseason, they can make some major strides. Build around him. Clean your house before you bring your baby home, please. Address your offensive line. Please work on your defensive front. Find a way to not use duct tape in your secondary one time and find a long-term solution. If they can improve those other areas, have Colt McCoy as their quarterback, they could be competitive, be a 7-win, 8-win type team next year, and then find your quarterback the following offseason.
Just really quickly, you can grow your offense around him, and you can grow your identity of what you are as an offense around him. I don't know if he's the long-term answer, but the rest of your players can continue to get better through him.
Should the Redskins draft a quarterback?
They do with Robert. I think it's a quarterback competition next year with Kirk and Colt.
Colt's had 2 weeks of first-team reps. He's had 2 weeks of first-team reps after being in mothballs for all that time. Mm-hmm. Let's give the guy a chance.
And you've had 12 weeks of this, and you're just doing it.
I know.
Jason Reed is fabulous from the Washington Post, and Grant Paulson from 106.7 The Fan. We're not done yet. Who's hot, who's not, and Rick Dockwalker, all coming up next. Stay with us right here on Redskins Showtime.